Hi friends, in the previous video I explained how to generate different types of waveforms like a sawtooth, triangular, square wave. Okay, now let us see in this particular video how 8086 will control the traffic lights. Okay, so here in order to implement this particular topic, so we are using 8086 trainer kit as well as traffic controllers interfacing chip. Okay, if these two are available, then with the help of micro processor we can control the traffic light LEDs easily. Okay, let us see what are the various LEDs that are present in the traffic light, then how we are controlling the flow of LEDs. Okay, see here. Let us see. I will take highlighter. See the topic: write an assembly language program to control the traffic lights. Write an assembly language program to control the traffic lights with the help of 8086 microprocessor and also 8255 peripheral chip. So which are required here? 8086 is essential. Okay, 8255 is required, and similarly traffic light controller chip is required. And if you observe the traffic light chip, okay, assume this is a traffic light. chip. So in the traffic light chip, if you take, so one side only I am focusing, like that all four sides will get same LEDs, same type of LEDs. Coming to south side, let us in south side, so we have a total 1 2 3 4 5 6 LEDs. Now these two comes like a one LED only. So what is the name of DL? Nothing but this is a LED for pedestrians. Here pedestrians means walkers. For example, south side walkers will move from this side to this side or this side to this side, then definitely these two must be in the green position. For example, pedestrians wants to stop, then these two must be red light. Like that these two will give you two types of lighting. One is green or red. Green indicates pedestrians will move from one side to other side. Red indicates pedestrians don't move from one side to other side. Like that these two put together act like a one LED only. Okay, related to pedestrians, maybe red or green. Okay, like that we have this LED for pedestrians. Now red. Now this is a red LED, and this red LED is used mainly for opposite side vehicles. See, whenever red light is on, then opposite side vehicles will be in the stopped position. Okay, now these three lights: red, amber, left, straight, and right. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5. Except to pedestrians LEDs. The other LEDs are related to opposite side people. Okay, red, amber. Okay, red indicates it's a red light. Okay, to stop the vehicles in the opposite side. A is amber. Amber indicates okay, this is the LED. It indicates that the state is changing. Means one side to other side state is changing. Means for example, one side is green, other side may be red. Later it will change. Like that, amber will give you alert. It indicates that there is a change in the state. Okay, that is called it as amber. Okay, alert LED. Then L indicates the left LED, S indicates right LED, R indicates right LED. Like that, we have six LEDs, right? Okay, amber, left, straight, right, and the other one is pedestrians LED. Total how many LEDs now? These two act like a one LED. Left LED 2, amber 3, red 4, straight 5, right 6. Total 6 LEDs. So one side 6 LEDs. Like that, total how many sides we have? 4 sides. So 6 fours, 24 LEDs are present in this particular. In this particular traffic light chip, 24 LEDs are present. So now let us see for controlling this particular LED. Okay, for example, I am sending 1 to this LED, then it will on. 0, it will off. Like that, we need how many pins are required to control 24 LEDs? I need 24 pins or 24 bits. For that, I am using how many ports? Each port is 8 only, but here how many are present? 24 LEDs are present. For controlling 24 LEDs, we need 3 ports. Port A, 8, plus port B, 8, plus port C, 8. Total, 3 8s, 24 ports, individual bits are used to enable or disable the LEDs of traffic light. Okay, this is very important. Right. So, consider each side we have total 6 LEDs. Red, amber, left, straight, and right. These five are opposite side vehicles. Okay, pedestrians for same side, south side vehicles. Okay, now here also one more important point is assume it's like a divider. Okay, now route should be like a divider. So for example, so the vehicles will go left like this, vehicles will go straight like this, right? Anyway, present, but preferably we are not using. So left and straight and light on left side only, vehicles will move. But right LED is also present. If it is right, vehicles will go like this. Okay, now let us see what is the best optimization way in order to move the vehicles or flow the vehicles. Okay, with the help of 8086 microprocessor. Okay, so this is the overview. Now, for example, south side red LED, I need to glow. So in ports, which port I need to enable? Okay, that is also important. For that, see this table, LEDs and corresponding port lines. So LED corresponding port line. See here, if we consider south side in order to glow a red LED, south side in order to glow red LED, which port must be enabled? Which port bit is enabled? PA3. So port A, third bit, if enable, then this light is glowing. Okay. Then similarly amber. Okay. In a south side, if you make amber into on, PA2 must be one. PA2 one, then amber is on. So similarly south side left LED in order to glow, PA0 must be enabled. Similarly, right straight in order to glow straight LED in the south side, then PC3 must be on. Similarly, right side south side right side LED must be glow means PA1 must be on. Pedestrians LEDs means these two. In order to glow these two LEDs, PC6 must be on. Like that, the manufacturer, okay, if you procure this particular interfacing controller chip from the any of the manufacturer will give you this type of pin description. So we follow. Okay, we follow same. We are not in a position to change red with instead of PA3 to some other. So we should take same into account. Okay, like that, this is south side. Similarly, east side also, we have six LEDs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, corresponding port pins. Similarly, north side also, we have six LEDs and corresponding port pins. Similarly, west side also, we have six LEDs and corresponding port pins. Like that, okay, so total how many port pins are present? 24. Port A8, port B8, port C8 put together, 24 they are distributing to sites and corresponding red or amber or light or sight or right or pedestrians related LEDs accordingly. Okay, now before entering into interfacing of 8086 with traffic light controller, first we should look into which side, which ports we should enable. Okay, for making a traffic light in efficient manner. Okay, we should analyze. Then other important point is now we know what is traffic light interfacing and what, how many LEDs are present and in which way we are enabling those LEDs we observed with respect to ports. Now for selecting these ports, we should select all ports. Now in the previous videos, we observed 8255 in which we use only one port for our operation. Maybe port A or port B or port C, only one port we are using for waveform generation or stepper motor control or something. But for traffic light here, 24 LEDs are there. That's why we need all three ports. So we should enable all three ports here. Okay. So in order to enable ports, what is our important input we are considering for enabling ports here? First, we should select for IO operation, D7 must be 1 in the control board register. Okay. So in order to make all ports are output ports, D4, D3, D1, D0, nothing but port A, port C upper, port B and port C lower must be all are output, nothing but all are zeros, 0, 0, 0, 0 like that. What is equivalent XA? 17 zeros. Equivalent XA is 80H. If you send 80H to 8255, especially control board register, then it understood that all ports are ready to perform which operation? Output operation. So this is also important. Now here we are using effectively all ports, whereas in other programs, in the previous programs, only one port we are using. But here all three are essential because of controlling 24 LEDs, all three ports are essential. Now coming to, now till now we observed what is the logic and we are considering. Now let us see what is the program, how we are writing. Right, so all of you observe carefully. The first part is move AL comma ATH. Okay, start indicates one label, later I will show you where we are indicating. So now here we are starting the program, move AL comma ATH. ATH is the value. If you make a ATH value, then all ports are ready to perform output. So then move DX comma 0 FF E6. So this is the control board register. Okay. So then out DX comma AL. So AD data is now moved to control board register. Then control board register understood that making all ports are ready to which operation? Output. And initialization of 8255 in which mode? Mode 0. So port A operates in mode 0. Port B also operates under mode 0 and all ports are ready to perform output operation. These three steps are common for all interfacing experiments. Remember. Then coming to here, now in initialization of ports are okay. Then what is the next one? Move SI comma 2038H. So move SI comma 2038 means my SI is equal to 2038. What is 2038? See, bottom of the program, I mention 2038. This is my 2038. So this is called it as a lookup table. So initially we are making which LEDs are on in the on the corresponding side. Accordingly, we can analyze here. We have five states: state one, state two, state three, state four, and state five. Okay. So coming to state one, so every state we have three ports: port A information, port B, and port C. Port A, what is the value? 10H. 10H means what is the equivalent binary? 0 0 0 1 4 zeros. So now where one is present, 0 0 0 1 means PA0, PA1, PA2, PA3 must be zeros only. PA4 must be one. So PA4 one means if you see data sheet once, PA4 one, where PA4 one is present, you can see here PA4 one present. PA4 is one now. So east side which LED is on? Left LED is on. Okay, if you select 10, then 81H. This is related to port B information. 81 means what is the equivalent binary? 1 3 zeros. Nothing but port B 7th bit is 1, then 3 zeros. Then 1 means 0 0 0 1 means port B 0 bit, port B 7th bit are ones. So let us say port B 0 bit. Okay, then which LED is on? We can understand port B 0 bit means north side left LED is on. Port B 7th bit. Port B 7th bit. West side red LED is on. Okay, like that we should analyze why he considered this type of data. So no need of by heart, just to verify once. Then 7A related to port C information. So this is port A, port B, and port C. 7A means 0 1 1, A means 1 0 1 0, correct? Then PC1, okay, then PC3 are ones. Similarly PC4, PC5, PC6 are ones. Okay, let us see this LEDs are on according to that data. So PC1 is 1, PC1. So then north side straight LED is on. Okay, PC3 means, let us see where it is. PC3, south side straight LED is on. Similarly PC4 means, let us see where it is. PC4, north side pedestrian is on. PC5, west side pedestrian is on. Like that we have look up data. So we should analyze. So now remember, this is port A data, port B, port C. Like that already predefined lookup data he given. So just you observe, okay, what happens 10 on, 10 provide 81, 70. Okay, but in even the examination point of view also, now this type of data they are given. So no need of by hearting. Okay, just I'm telling you how we can map. So like that, similarly state 2, between state 1 and state 2, let us see all ambers on will appear. So all ambers on means all sides vehicles will alert. Okay, all traffic vehicles will alert because change state is changing. Alert. State 2 to state 3 also all ambers on. If all ambers on, what is the data? 44. Port A 44. Port B also 44. Port C should be F0. Accordingly, the corresponding LEDs will glow. Okay, like that we should understand. So now this is 2038. In the 2038 location, which data is present? 10. 2039 location 81, 2038 location 7A. Like that, if you continue locations, so now this 00 appears in which location? 2056H. 2056 is the last location in our table. And here, what is state 1 means? One side pedestrians will move. State 2, another side pedestrians will move. State 3, another side pedestrians will move. State 4, fourth side pedestrians will move. Accordingly, we are controlling the vehicles. State 5. So state 5 nothing but it's one beautiful state. In that state all side vehicles will stop, but all side pedestrians will move from one side to other side. All four sides pedestrians will move. That stage is called as a state 5. State 5 means all side pedestrians will move. Okay, all side vehicles will stop. That is called as a state 5. Then again all ambers are on. After state 5 again it will come to first state. Like that it will continue. Okay, now let us see program where I stopped. Okay, now this is a brief background. So initialization is over, then what is first step? Move SI comma 2038. Okay, so why I'm taking 2038? From that only we have starts the lookup data. Okay, then what is next step? Move AL comma box of SI. So what is my AL? Now AL is nothing but it's a lower accumulator register, and it will take data from the 2038 location. Which data is available in this example? 10. So 10H. So now this 10H data is now 10H data is now moved to AL. AL is now available 10H data. Now, where I need to send this 10H data into port A. For that, see here, move DX comma 0 FFE 0. This is a port A address. Then I'm writing out DX comma A. So AL already having 10. The 10 is now moved to port A. Then accordingly, port A bits are taking 10H value. Accordingly, which port is one, the corresponding LED will glow. Because internally, 8255 ports are connected to the corresponding LEDs. If it is 1, it will enable. 0, off, like that. Then increment SI. Increment SI means what is SI originally? 2038. If increment SI, what is SI now? 2039 means here. 2039 means I need 81 data. So 81H data is available in which location? 2039. 38 is this one. 2039. For that, I am incrementing SI. See here, now I am incrementing SI. SI is now 2039. 38 becomes 39 here. 2039. Then add DX comma 2. Why I am adding? Because already DX equal to which value? 0FFE0H. This is the port A address. But I need port B address. Where port B address is available? 0FFE2. For that, I am adding DX with which value? 2. Add DX comma 2. Then what is my DX now? 0FFE2H. Then move AL comma box of SI. Then my AL takes which value? The data that is present in 2039H. 2039 memory location. Which data is present? 2039 memory location? 81. So now 81 data will go to, say 81 data will go to, 81 data will go to which one? Port B. Like that, port B receiving 81 data from 2039. So like that, port A is taking data from 2038, port B taking data from 2039. Then port C will take data from 2038. For that, increment SI. Then what is SI now? 2039 becomes 2038. Then add DX comma 2H. Then what is the DX here? 0FFE2. Now added to 2. What is DX now? 0FFE4. That is the address of port C. Then move AL comma box of SI. So AL now receiving data from 2038. Which data is available? Data that is available in the 2038 is, in our example, 78. 78 data now move to AL. Then out DX comma AL. That 78 data now move to port C. Okay, like that, port A, port B, port C receiving the data from the locations 2038, 39 and 2038. Okay, like that, one state values are moving. Then what is next one? Increment SI. What is SI now? 2038 becomes 203B. Then after incrementing, I'm writing call delay. This is important, call delay. Because I need to provide those values to corresponding LEDs and those LEDs should be on with that specified delay. For that, I need to provide delay. Okay, call delay is essential after making LEDs into R. How much time those LEDs are on, that is decided by delay. So call delay. There is one instruction. Whenever call delay is executing, what happens? Processor will go from main to sub. Where delay is there, it will go jump directly to this delay. Then move CX comma 0FF. This much delay I am providing. Okay, so during this delay, what happens? Now same LEDs are on. Move CX comma 0FFH. Instead of writing push CH, all are optional. So instead of writing all these instructions, simply write NOP. NOP means no operation, no operation. Loop, loop. Something like a delay 5. For example, loop, delay 5 is okay. Push CX means the CX value will be pushed to stack memory. Then move CX comma 03FF. Then no operation. Like that, simply these instructions will provide delay. Means in the delay, what happens? Whatever it may be, the LEDs are on in state 1. Same LEDs are on up to this much delay. So this is the instructions relating to delay. So simply he pushed the CX value to stack memory. Okay, the later pop delay, no operation. Then okay, for this instruction with this CX value, what happens? CX is decrementing by 1 and checking whether CX is 0 or not. With this time the same LEDs are on. Pop CX means moving data from stack memory to CX register. Okay, then loop delay 5. Like that, only these instructions are used to provide delay. So instead of writing this many instructions, simply you write move CX comma 0FFH, then NOP, NOP, NOP. Okay, instead of writing push CH, delay 5 if and you can write NOP, 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 loop delay 5 is okay. That many times your loop is continuous and at that time same LEDs are on. Then return. After return, what happens? No, delay is over. So whenever whenever CX completely comes to all zeros, then it will stop. It will comes to next line return. If you write return, it will change from subprogram to main program. Then your program will, your processor will go to next line of call. What is next line of call? Compare. It will comes here. Like that, one state is over. In that state, with respect to that particular delay, with that delay, same LEDs are on up to that time. Then after that, now in order to go to next stage, it will come here. Compare which value SI with 2056. Already two SI is how much? SI is how much initially here? SI is 203B. Is it 2056? No. Then what happens? Here checking jump no zero. These two are not same. SI is now not reached to. SI now up to now this state is only. But what is the last one? 2056. Is it reached? No. Okay. Then comparison is over. So we are not completing all stages. Okay, then SI is now 203B. 2023B is 3839 3A over then 3B. 3B is not 2056. 203P is not 2056. Then jump no zero. These two are not same. Then what happens? It will jump to which one? Next stage. For that NEXT ST ST is the one label I'm calling. Next stage. It will go here. Then my AL takes data from which one? 203B. So nothing but which data AL will take? 44. So 44 will go to here. 44 will go to AL. Then AL sending that value to 48. Then 3x0FF. This is the 40 address. AL sending 44 to 48. Then SI is incrementing. Then SI is now 203B becomes 203C. Nothing but another 44. Port B related. 44 is present. 44 is present in 203B also. 203389AB. Now C 203C. Okay, now increment SI like that. Then again add DX comma 2, nothing but port A address becomes port B address. Then AL takes data from 203C. Then that value will be moved to port B, then port C. And again after making AMBUS related information to port A, port B and port C, then again incrementing SI. What is SI now? Next instruction. Next to location. Then call delay. Again we are calling same delay. So what is your observation after completion of state 1? All AMBERs are on with that condition. Which LEDs are on? Those LEDs are on up to this delay. Up to this delay. Up to this delay. Okay. Then later what happens now? We are moving next one, next one, next one continuously. One after other. In the same manner. Okay. And if you move like this, we can generate controlling of LEDs in effective manner. Okay. Right. And at the end, whenever SI reaches to last location 2056, we can say that all states are over. Then after SI reaches to 2056, if this condition is failed, then it will come here. Jump again. Jump again means where I am writing again. Again, my SI starts with which value? 2038. Like that, whenever it reaches to last location, again it will comes to original. Like that, after state 5, state 1 will occur again and it will continue. Wherever power is available, same LEDs will glow one after other continuously. Okay, this is the way we can control traffic lights. Okay, now let us see how we can write same program in the 8086 trainer kit and how we are controlling LEDs practically. Now let us see.
Let us see here how we are controlling the traffic LEDs with the help of 8086 processor. Okay, let us say this is your 8086 trainer kit and here it requires a 5 volt supply. For that I am connecting an adapter. Okay, so internally this trainer kit itself having 8086 chip as well as 8255, some memories, okay, some ports are present. This is your traffic light interfacing chip. Okay, if you observe here, so traffic light interfacing chip, every side contains total 6 LEDs. Okay, in the first part of the presentation I was already explained, right? Let us see here. Okay, so now if you take east side reference or south side, for example, south side reference, if you consider these two LEDs are related to pedestrians. Okay, now these two LEDs will be considered like a count one LED only as per count. So for example, if these two LEDs are green, then pedestrians will move from this side to this side easily. So in that case, no vehicles will come to this side. For that, see here, red light must be on for the opposite vehicles. Okay, like that, okay, we are selecting the LEDs accordingly. We are giving the lookup table data here. So now these two related to pedestrians, it may glow either green or red. Green indicates pedestrians will move, red indicates pedestrians stop, no movement. So this is a red LED, and this red LED for opposite vehicles, and this is amber LED. So it indicates that state is changing, try to alert, like that amber. Then this is a left LED, this is right LED, and this is right LED. Like that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six total, six LEDs are present in each side. Let us see how we can control all these LEDs with the help of 8086 microprocessor programming part. Okay, so first let us see what is the program. Okay, so here I was typed the program in 2000 location. ASPACE 2000, in that I am writing MOU LKMIAT, like that in theory part I was already explained all the instructions, same instructions I was typed here, okay, delay everything, okay, I was typed, and even I was given the lookup table data also here, okay, like that, so I was typed the complete program here, up to 2056, so we have your instructions, our program instructions. So lookup table data also we entered here. Okay, now let us see how to control the LEDs. So for that we should type it like a G equal to 2000 command for running. So for that first you connect patch card. If you connect patch card, automatically all LEDs will glow. Okay, if we can observe it. Now G equal to 2000 if you type, let us see what happens. So it will start from east side. So now it then it will go states effectively first east. Okay, I will explain again. So now see here, in this case what happens, all pedestrians will move fifth state. So this is first state, ampersand, then second state, again ampersand, then third state, after that again ampersand, then fourth state, again ampersand, then fifth state is nothing but pedestrian will move from all the sides. Okay, then again it will start first state, second state, like that. So because it's uncontrolled jump I am using, it will continue. So like that, see here, fifth state, again first state, okay, then ampersand, then second state, again ampersand, then third state, again ampersand, then fourth state, again ampersand, fifth state, nothing but the pedestrians will move from all the sides. Like that we can control the LEDs using 8086 processor. Okay.
Thank you for watching this video. Okay, if you really like it, please kindly share my video to your friends. Okay, subscribe my channel. Thank you.